And the way that we're going to prove that the halting problem is undecidable is by using a technique known as a proof by contradiction, which means that I will first assume that the halting problem is in fact decidable, and then show you that this assumption leads to an unresolvable contradiction. So let's start out by assuming that the halting problem is in fact decidable. So it follows directly from the assumption that the halting problem is decidable that there must be some algorithm for the halting problem. Now this algorithm can be very sophisticated, very complicated, whatsoever, but since the halting problem is decidable, or since we assume that the halting problem is decidable, we can directly conclude from this assumption that there must be some algorithm solving it, no matter what the program, no matter what the input. So now that we assume that we have this halt algorithm, what we're now going to do is something sneaky, and this will lead us to the proof by contradiction. We're going to write a program that uses this algorithm here. And this program I call inverse halt, and it's defined as following. So inverse halt takes as input a program, so not a program and input, but just a program, and then it calls the halt algorithm with two inputs. So the first input is again the program, just as in halt, but it also gives the program source code itself, if you will, as an input to halt. So it's basically the question of what happens if I give a program its own program code as an input. And the way this then reacts is the following. If halt says the program, when it's fed its own code, will stop, then inverse halt, that's why I call it inverse halt, will go into an infinite loop. So if program stops on being fed itself, then inverse halt of that program will not stop. It will not halt. If, on the other hand, halt determines that program, given itself as an input, would not stop, so go into an infinite loop, then this whole program here, inverse halt, would in fact terminate. And we're guaranteed in this case that the overall program inverse halt will terminate, because we know that halt is guaranteed to terminate. After all, it's a valid algorithm that solves the halting problem for any program and any input. Now we're almost there. There's just one more step missing to arrive at our proof by contradiction. And that is that we now run the following program. So we are almost ready to our proof by contradiction. And to actually conclude the proof, we'll now consider the following program. We run inverse halt with inverse halt as an input. So it's kind of similar to up here. We consider inverse halt in two ways. This one up here is the program inverse halt that we actually run. And this here is inverse halt, if you will, it's the source code of inverse halt that we want to analyze. So it's similar to up here again. We're considering a program both as an actual algorithm, but also the description of that algorithm. And what we're now going to show is that inverse halt, when given inverse halt as an input, is going to basically choke on itself. And of course, we're going to do this as a quiz.